Representation, you have suicide.
Dr. Hina gave it.
Exit is okay. Exit test is okay, but what should there be exit test for post graduation? So we, Honorable Minister, is expected to give a second look. First is about.
Yes. We are not recording.
Sir, I rise to support the National Medical Commission Bill 2019. This bill is, in a sense, a very important bill, because it is going to replace the Medical Council of India, and a new National Medical Commission is being framed in the country for improving the medical education. So the bill proposes creation of a new institutional framework in the form of National Medical Commission, Medical Advisory Council, and four autonomous boards for regulating all the aspects related to medical education, medical profession, and medical institutions. The National Medical Commission will formulate and lay down policies for regulating medical education and develop a roadmap for meeting the requirements in the healthcare, including human resource and infrastructure. Bill also proposes to create four autonomous boards with a clear demarcation of functions to regulate various aspects of medical education institution and practice: the Undergraduate Medical Education Board, the Postgraduate Medical Education Board, the Medical Assessment and Rating Board, and Ethics and Medical Registration Board. So the National Medical Commission will have one chairman, 10 ex officio members, and 14 part-time members, and the entire selection process is going to be done by the search committee. This is in a way bringing in transparency in the selection process, appointment of chairperson, secretary, and part-time members. Also, sir, to bring in more transparency, because what we have seen in MCI earlier, the same people were becoming the chairman, the same people were repeated as members of the MCI. And just to bring a proper transparent process, the government has included a provision which says that the chairperson and part-time members will hold office for maximum period of 4 years and will not be eligible for any extension or reappointment. So not only this, the Medical Advisory Council will advise the Commission on measures to determine, to maintain, and to coordinate maintenance of minimum standards in all matters related to medical education, training, and research. Sir, again, one more step towards bringing in transparency is in Section 6 of this bill. The government has introduced a provision where the chairperson and the members of the commission will have to declare their assets and liabilities when they take the charge of the office, and they will also have to declare about their assets and liabilities at the time when they vacate that office. So, sir, earlier when there was MCI, there always used to be charges of corruption, and sir, because of this Section 6 being introduced in the bill, a transparency will be followed. This entire information is going to be available in the public domain, so any person in the country will have an access to all this information that will be declared by the chairperson and the members. And sir, when our Prime Minister says Saaf Niyat Sahi Vikas, this is a move towards the right, the clear intent and the right development. Sir, also a provision in this same section is that a person who is a chairperson or has been a member on this commission cannot work in any private medical college as an advisor or as a consultant for at least 2 years after demitting his office as a chairperson or as a member. So this is again a very good step taken by the government. Sir, I would just like to throw some light on Section 10(1)(i), which says framing of guidelines for deciding the fee structure of private medical colleges up to 50%. So, Section 29 says the criteria for approving or disapproving of establishment of a new medical college. Sir, I would like to request Honorable Minister, when we have formed a criteria for starting a new medical college, when there is a fixed criteria of what are the things required in a medical college, then why there should be a difference in the fees taken from the students? Now, when we say that fixing fees of only 50% of the students, like regulating the fee of 50% of the students, sir, we are taking admission of all the students in a private medical college through one entrance, one merit list, then how can we differentiate on taking the fees different from a person from the same merit list and different from some other? So I would request the Honorable Minister to kindly clarify on this, what is going to be the criteria. And sir, along with this, I also would like to request the Honorable Minister, the next exam which is introduced in this bill, which is also going to be a licentiate exam, which is going to be a PG entrance exam, and which is also going to be an licentiate exam for those students who are foreign medical graduates. Sir, what will be the pattern of this exam? And if a student who clears this exam but doesn't get a field of post-graduation of his own choice, what will be the option for that? Whether the student has to again appear for the same exam? And sir, in this, I just, because I am myself a doctor and I have undergone this entire process, I just would like to request the Honorable Minister, when there are practical exams, there is a factor of being biased, or and there is, if a student has some grudges or a teacher has some grudges regarding a student, there are possibilities that he would purposely be given less marks, or there can be possibility just to favor some students, some more marks will be given. So, sir, when we are talking of the next exam, regarding the practical, I would request the minister that the practical exams should not be taken in the same institute where the student is studying. There should be a complete transparent process so that no chances of bias will exist in this. So many of the members of parliament have spoken about shortage of doctors. I would like to congratulate minister that in this bill, the process of starting of a new medical college has been fixed a time frame, and that is why starting of a new medical college will now have a time, will be now in a time bound manner, and we can have more number of medical colleges in the country. And sir, along with this, my one concern is about the community health provider. In the earlier bill of 2017, the National Medical Commission Bill 2017, there was something called as bridge course. Sir, now I would like to throw some light on the fact that in the rural areas, in the villages, in smaller towns, Ayurvedic homeopathic doctors are the ones who take care of the health in the rural areas. And sir, in my state, that is in Maharashtra, there is a bridge course already from more than 5 years. Many doctors have passed this bridge course and are really giving very good service in the rural areas. Sir, I would request the Honorable Minister that in the bill they have mentioned only about community health provider, but whether there is going to be any capacity building, any kind of training that will be given to the health professionals. Kindly, sir, I request you to kindly clarify about this. And sir, lastly, I would like to mention about the DNB course. The DNB is a very important course in the country. Sir, most of the DNB courses are in the private hospitals. Very few DNB courses are in the teaching institutes. Now, I am, sir, a PG student. I have myself done post-graduation from a medical college. And I would like to bring to the notice of the House that while doing post-graduation in a medical college, there are regular clinics, there are case presentations, and there are lectures. So I'm just concluding. Last point, sir. So, sir, when we are talking about the DNB courses being run in private hospitals, sir, not many hospitals have teaching facility, not many hospitals have clinics. Just a student gets admission in the DNB, the professor would come in the morning for the rounds, just teach something over an hour or so, and then go back. So, sir, I would request the Honorable Minister that there is a provision in the bill which says that the DNB courses, which will be in the medical institutes or those where the hospital is of 500 bedded strength, will be considered equivalent to the postgraduate or equivalent to super speciality. I would request the Honorable Minister to kindly make little change in this, and those students who are bringing in, who are DNB students in non-teaching institutes, they should also be given a chance to do 1 year senior residency in a teaching institute, and then they should be recognized equivalent to postgraduate or super speciality. So with these words, I wholeheartedly support the bill. Thank you.
Sir, I oppose this bill. Preamble and object and reason of this bill looks good, awful and meaningful.
But if we do a critical analysis, we can see a lot of bend, curves and deep ditches in this bill. In a way, this is an old wine in the new bottle, and up to an extent, this is not progressive. On the other hand, this is regressive. Sir, there were many commissions on this. Espal Committee in 2009, then Standing Committee on NMC Bill 2017, which submitted this report on 2018 March. Expert committee under chairmanship of Professor Ranjit Roy Chowdhury, the Niti Aayog and National Knowledge Commission, they have also made recommendations. Unfortunately, I think the government have not applied their mind about the serious recommendations of this commission.